Okay, so today we're going to discuss how to add and subtract fractions. Okay, so first of all, just thinking about a fraction, let's go ahead and start thinking about a pizza. And let's say that you ate half the pizza. So I shaded the amount of pizza that you ate. And let's say that your friend was eating a pizza of the same size and ate, let's say, this much of the pizza. Okay, so you ate half the pizza and your friend ate, well, how much did your friend eat? The pizza, the whole pizza's been divided into three parts, one, two, three, and your friend ate two of those, so your friend ate 2/3 of the entire pizza. Okay, so the question is, how much did you and your friend eat together? You ate half of one pizza and your friend ate 2/3, and the question is what is 1/2 plus 2/3? How do you add two fractions together? Well, part of the problem is that you see, you ate a slice that was pretty big. The slice that you ate was half of the whole pizza, and your friend ate smaller slices, right? Well, they were smaller, but your friend ate two of them. So actually, your friend ate more pizza than you, but each slice was smaller. So if we want to, maybe say, oh, how many slices were eaten? We can't say, well, two of any one slice right now because your slices are a lot bigger than your friend's slices. So fractions have a really interesting property, and it's that there are multiple ways of representing, for example, this quantity. You know, 1/2, but 1/2 represents this, but the idea behind it is that I've taken a whole and I've divided it into two pieces. What if I took that whole pizza and I did this? I cut it like that, and then I cut it like that. Well, you still ate the same amount of pizza. You still ate, all of this, but clearly each slice is, well, 1/6 of the pizza. And how many of those did you eat? You ate 1/2, 3/6. So we see that 1/2 is the same thing as 3/6. Kind of an amazing property of fractions that you can represent the same quantity in two different ways. So 1/2 is the same as 3/6, and likewise over here I can see it, I can do the same thing to this pizza. I can cut it like so, and I can see, that my friend ate, well, this pizza's been chopped into six pieces as well, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and my friend ate 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. So eating 2/3 of the pizza is the same thing as eating 4/6. Now what's nice about this is that if I ate 3/6 and my friend ate 4/6, well now I can actually say that together we ate 7/6 because our slice sizes are the same. So what we do is we look at this fraction, we say, okay, 1/2, that's the same thing as 3/6, and 2/3 likewise is the same as 4/6. And then when I add those together, as we just mentioned, that's the same thing as 7/6. So when you add two fractions together, you have to make sure that your denominators are the same. So at first my denominators were, a 2 and a 3. That's because the first pizza was originally chopped into two pieces and the other pizza was chopped into three pieces. But then I said, hey, both pizzas can be chopped into six pieces. And what was crucial was that 1/2 was the same as 3/6 in the same way that 2/3 is the same as 4/6. So when two fractions have the same denominator, then you go ahead and add their numerators, and in this case I got 7/6. And that's how you add and also subtract two fractions.